very sad news in the health sector. Away from that, the Minister of Local Government has today told off the Line Committee at Parliament that they do not have money to pay for the newly elected councillors. The minister says though they had budgeted for the councillors, finance has not provided funds after the numbers did increase. We have the report.
Launch and operationalization of 10 new cities. These are Arua, Mbarara.
While appearing before the Parliamentary Committee on Public Service and Local Government for their ministerial policy statement for the coming financial year 2021-2022, the Minister of Local Government and MP Gara West, Rafael Majeze, told the MPs of how they are also in dismay over the funding gap for the new councillors that have not been catered for in this financial year.
Local governments get advance in the first quarter. We look at what they collected the previous year, and Minister of Finance gives them an advance, and then they collect and pay back to Treasury. When they have filled the amount they received, they get a replenishment. That is where we have had a challenge. And I would love Uluga to consider this, both the positive and negatives, and give a well-guided recommendation.
But there is a ray of light for the new cities that have been in a bad state since they were commissioned but had never kicked off independently. Majeze says these have been allocated funds in the coming budget starting July to manage several of their works like infrastructure development, garbage management and staffing.
Honorable Chairman, I don't want to hide this one. The district chairpersons have been asking for the DMCs, they call them DMCs, the vehicles in dangerous mechanical condition, that they be allowed to take home the vehicles which they are now using. And one of them yesterday put it, said, but if Parliament has allowed them to go with their iPads, why can't we also take our vehicles?
Majeze, however, denied the plea of outgoing district chairpersons that have been asking government to let them keep the old cars and they have been using while in office for the last 5 years. The minister says this cannot be possible because it will mean buying new cars all over again for the incoming district chairpersons, which money is not available.
A vehicle now, for us to say today, all district chairpersons take the vehicles you have, that is extremely difficult. You have to go through the PPDA, but also we are not prepared starting July to have vehicles for the new team. So my own proposal, in line with the recommendations of Olga, let us work together to have a comprehensive welfare and pension scheme for our local government leaders.
But new cars have been budgeted for and to be provided for the mayors of new cities and district chairpersons for the new districts. The long-awaited bicycles for LCs and motorcycles for the sub-county chairpersons are to be received starting July.
Budget. We have put in provision for new vehicles for the 10 city mayors and the 8 new district chairpersons. The process of procurement of motorcycles for all LOC3 chairpersons is also underway. We have already issued the contract. We expect by around August these LOC3 chairpersons will get new motorcycles. But management of these assets is under public service.
The minister confirms that in conjunction with the Minister of ICT, they are to procure tablets for parish chiefs and computers for every sub-county, and this is under the parish model implementation. The permanent secretary to the Minister of Local Government, Ben Bimanya, told the committee that the new cities will operate under the Local Government Act for now, but with time, they are to bring up the city's law. Story by Rachel Nakasi and Obed Lutale for the new.